Hello guys, and welcome to PowerBIZone. Today we are going to learn about a very powerful function in Dax called ALL. Before we go to the nitty-gritties of ALL, I request you to go ahead, if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, go ahead and please subscribe to learn new concepts in Dax. Now, what is ALL function and why it is used? So basically, the ALL function removes the applied filter from either a table or a column. This is going to be the syntax. Inside ALL, we'll either give a table name or a column name. It's very simple. So having understood the syntax and the usage, let us quickly go ahead and see some real life example. Let us quickly deep dive to example one, where I have simply pulled in two columns. The first column is that of country. The second column is that of sales. Now the sales, if you see, represents for each and every country. The first row is for Mexico, the second row for Germany, the third row for France, giving their corresponding sales and so on. Now obviously, as I have explained in the earlier videos, this visual is being filtered by the filter context. For the first row, Mexico's sales comes into the picture. For the second row, Germany gets filtered. For the third row, France gets filtered. So there is an internal filter context for this visual, right? And apart from that, if I can go ahead and manipulate this, choosing any particular country or year from the two filters that are available in my slicers, right? Now let's say there is a requirement where I want the total sales. What is the total sales? The total sales is this figure, 1187, which is a combination of the sales for all the five countries, right? Now let's say I want to ignore this filter context. I want to ignore the filter context of Mexico, Germany, France, and so on, right? So wow, you will do that. For that, you have to use your ALL, right? So let us go ahead and see what is the DAX that I have written for this ALL sales. So what you need is a measure called ALL sales, which actually gives you the entire sales for all the countries, right? So inside calculate, you will say that give me the sum of sales, and you will write the ALL function, and inside ALL you will give your country, which means remove all the filters from country. That's it. So let me go ahead and pull this and show you. So we select all sales, and that's it. So 1187 is repeated for all the rows. That is, for any rows, the filter context won't come into the picture. Me, why do we need this? So look, if I say that this is my total sales, and I want to see how much percentage of sales Mexico is making, what is the percentage of sales by Germany, and so on. Ultimately, I just divide this sales divided by all sales, and if I pull this sales over here, you see 17% of the sales is going to come from Mexico, 19% from Germany, and so on. Let us say I will choose only three countries, right, from the slicer. So let me choose Canada, France, and Germany, right? Obviously Canada, France, and Germany will be filtered. You'll be able to see the data only for these three, but look at all sales, right? All sales is still giving you 1187, which means still all, although you have selected these three countries from the slicer, then also it is going to give you the sales for all the five countries, not only the three countries that you have selected, right? Why? That's because inside all you have given country, which is what you're telling all. Remove the filter from the entire country column. Maybe that country can be present in the visual level or in the slicer level, but remove that. That's why you're getting 1187. Now, interestingly, what will happen if I select year 2013 and year 2014, right? You see, this value will automatically change based on 2013, which gives 264, and 2014, which gives 923, correct? Why it is changing? That's because you did not specify inside all this year column, right? So inside all what we have written only the country column. That means it's going to remove the filters which are applied only for country, not for year. So it will work for year. That's why the values are changing, correct? I hope you are crystal clear with the explanation for all, right? Now a very important interview question which comes with all is all powerful enough to ignore the report level filter or not? To answer this question, Let me go ahead and apply a report level filter first of all. Let me go ahead and drag and drop this filter only for, look over here, in the slicer 5 countries are available, right? Now if I go ahead and choose the report level filter as Canada, France and Germany and neglect these two, if I do not select this, you see these two values are removed from the slicer. That means I am applying a very powerful filter called the report level filter, right, which is applied for all the pages. Now even if I do that, what is happening, if you see in the all, if I go ahead and deselect this 2014, you see all is still giving me the sales for all the 5 countries. That means, in short, all is ignoring the report level filter also. One more example of all, you can just use all to create a simple table. So if I select this and show you the DAX that I have written to create this table, it's just inside all I have given country column, right, which is what it is doing. It is going to just pick up the distinct value from the country column and show it to you. So it will create a table with the distinct values of the country column. That's it, guys. I request you to please subscribe and click the bell icon to get all the updates, and it is through your subscription that will keep me motivated to make much more useful videos in DAX. So thank you and have a great day. Bye bye.